Hello you all, this is JTI 2007, and I'll be speaking upon the subject of removing the veil from our hearts. How can people or an individual accept the truth of when they have the veil covering their hearts? Now you may ask, I don't see a veil covering my heart, but the reason why people may ask that question is because the veil that's covering their hearts isn't a natural physical veil that they can see covering their hearts in an X-ray, but a spiritual veil that's covering their hearts because their hearts are turned away from the Most High God in Christ, but turned to the cares and wonders of this world. Think of it this way, in a carnal sense. When you go to a wedding, the bride has a veil covering her face. When the bride is ready to fully commit herself to her husband, the obedience she has in her heart signals the husband to remove the veil from her face / eyes. Now with that being said, let's look at it spiritually, dealing with the Most High God in Christ, in a spiritual sense. We as individuals are the creations of the Most High God. We come into this world with a veil covering our hearts, because at that point, we don't know anything from right and wrong towards the Most High God. When we get ready to make that commitment, at whatever age we make that commitment to the Most High God in Christ, with the obedience of our hearts, that signals the Most High God in Christ to remove the veil from our hearts. But the longer the veil is covering our hearts spiritually, the more we individually miss out of the good news, true knowledge, true understanding, true belief, and true wisdom of who the Most High God, Christ, and the Holy Spirit truly are, and how much importance the Most High God, Christ, and the Holy Spirit can really mean to us individually. Because, but even unto this day, when Moses is wed, the veil is upon their heart. 2 Corinthians chapter 3, verse 15, from the King James Version. Nevertheless, when it shall turn to the Lord, the veil shall be taken away. 2 Corinthians chapter 3, verse 17, from the King James Version. When we as individuals remove the veil from our hearts and allow our hearts to turn to the Most High God, as mentioned in 2 Corinthians chapter 3, verse 17, we then become free from sin. Romans chapter 6, verse 18 and verse 22. And by being free from sin, we continually deny ourselves and take up our individual cross and follow Christ. Luke chapter 9, verse 23. And to fight our flesh, Romans chapter 8, verse 13. Then we individually will continue to be free from sin. Romans chapter 6, verse 18, from the King James Version. Being then made free from sin, yea, became the servants of righteousness. Romans chapter 6, verse 22, from the King James Version. But now being made free from sin, and become servants to God, yea, have your fruit unto holiness, in the end, everlasting life. Luke chapter 9, verse 23, from the King James Version. And he said to them all, if any man will come after me, let him deny himself, and take up his cross daily, and follow me. Romans chapter 8, verse 13, from the King James Version. For if ye live after the flesh, ye shall die. But if ye through the Spirit do mortify the deeds of the body, ye shall live. To people who really want to believe and follow the Most High God in Christ, and for those that do believe and follow the Most High God in Christ, but are straggling and not do what you're supposed to do in regards to you believing and following the Most High God in Christ, then remove the veil from your hearts and accept the good news, true knowledge, true understanding, true belief, and true wisdom of the Most High God's holy word, because, and ye shall know the truth, and the truth shall make you free. John chapter 8, verse 32, from the King James Version. Thanks for listening. Peace.